Hi guys, and welcome in this presentation. I'm Adrian.
And I'm Anthony.
And today we are going to present a paper that Anthony and his collaborators recently wrote called Real-Time Semantic Background Subtraction.
Thanks, Adrian. This presentation will include some very cool topics such as background subtraction, semantic segmentation, and real-time processing. Let's go! Before we start, for those of you who are familiar with background subtraction, you can directly jump to this timestamp, because we will start with a brief introduction to the field.
Okay, let's jump right into the main objective of this work, background subtraction, which is also called motion detection. The objective is to segment all the moving parts of a scene by classifying each pixel into one of the two following categories: the foreground for the moving objects and the background for the static parts. Let's take a look at a simple example. In this video filming a street, we can see that there are some moving objects, such as people and cars. These are the objects that we are interested in. We want to compute, for each frame, a segmentation mask of all the moving objects. This information can be used, for example, for video surveillance or traffic monitoring. Okay, now that we know what it is and what it can be used for, let's have a look at how it used to work before the era of deep learning. Most background subtraction algorithms were made of three components. One, a background model that will be constructed gradually. Two, a distance function used to compare the current image with the background model. Three, an update strategy to update the background model based on the new image.
This is a very simple but effective pipeline, and most background subtraction algorithms rely on this principle. However, there exist some well-known issues. For example, a person's shadow may move but should not be considered as a moving object. Or, on a partially cloudy day, luminosity changes can destabilize the algorithm. Also, if, for example, a gray car comes in front of a gray building, it can be considered as not in motion. This is known as the camouflage effect. As you can imagine, these classical approaches have the advantage of being quite easy to implement, but they have some major drawbacks. This is where deep learning approaches come in handy. It is in 2016 that my two co-authors on this paper, Marc and Marc, presented for the first time ever a deep learning convolutional neural network for the task of background subtraction. In this work, they completely pulverized the state-of-the-art on CDNet 2014. Then, other innovative methods followed, such as RCNN or encoder-decoder-based architectures. They are now the state-of-the-art by far compared to unsupervised methods.
At this point, you might wonder why anyone would bother using unsupervised methods, since supervised deep learning algorithms seem to be the way. Well, there is a major disadvantage of using supervised methods. They need huge amounts of data. Also, it is believed that there might be quite some overfitting since the scenes are almost the same throughout the video.
Okay, so what do we do with this? Should we stay with unsupervised methods or go with a deep learning one? Well, what we propose in this work is to go with a hybrid approach, combining both an old-school background subtraction algorithm with newer semantic segmentation techniques.
Semantic background subtraction, also called SBS, is a method that combines the decision of two classifiers: any background subtraction algorithm and a semantic classifier. Here is how it works. For each frame, two signals are computed: a motion detection map, just like we've seen before, and a semantic map. The semantic map corresponds to a semantic segmentation of the frame. Each pixel is classified into one category: humans, cars, truck, whatever the pixel belongs to. Then, a semantic-based classifier decides for each pixel whether it belongs to an object that might be in motion. If the semantic information is too low, the pixel is classified as background. If the semantic information has increased compared to a semantic background model, the pixel is classified as foreground. In the other cases, the classifier gives the I don't know class for the pixel. Finally, the background subtraction and the semantic classifier are combined with a set of rules. Basically, the semantic classifier imposes its choice whenever it takes a foreground or background decision. Only when it doesn't know, then the background subtraction is listened to. The authors show that they improve the performance of any background subtraction algorithm thanks to the semantic classifier. This is a fantastic result!
Great, but don't get excited too soon. This work relies on a pretty strong assumption that the semantic information is available for each frame of the video. This is not guaranteed in a real-time application. In fact, semantic segmentation is often much slower to compute than background subtraction. Let's represent this on a time diagram. You've got the frames that come at a regular pace and the background subtraction that follows along. The semantic segmentation might not be able to keep up. There, the semantic information can only help background subtraction one in every few frames, which is underproductive. At this point, if you want to satisfy the real-time constraint, you have two options. Either you stick with the best segmentation network, even if they are not real-time, but you have to skip some frames, or you choose less performant but faster networks. Spoiler alert, the second option does not work well. This is why we decided to upgrade the first option so that our application runs in real time. What we need to do is to provide a surrogate for the semantic segmentation when it is not available. This is the basics of our method that we call real-time semantic background subtraction, or RTSBS for short. Here is how it works. We simply look at the previous available semantic information for each pixel. This gives us some information about which object is present. Of course, we cannot completely trust this information, as the objects might have moved between the frames. To know whether or not we should trust this previous semantic information, we propose to use a change detection algorithm. This algorithm will indicate whether or not a pixel and its surrounding have significantly changed. In the cases where the pixel has not changed too much, we can still trust the previous semantic information, and so we apply the decision again. Otherwise, we do not trust it and rely on the decision of the background subtraction algorithm. In our case, we choose a very simple change detection algorithm. This is to show that even with a very simple one, our method works well. It consists in computing the Manhattan distance between the current frame pixel and the frame pixel at which the semantic was computed. The pixels with a distance larger than some thresholds are considered as two different, and so we don't use the previous semantic information. The thresholds depend on the foreground or background nature of the pixel, as these two do not have the same dynamics.
Okay. Now that we know how to replace the semantic information when it is unavailable, can we use this method with any background subtraction algorithm? Well, unfortunately, no. If we look at the top algorithms on CDNet, most of them are not real-time. This means that even if we fixed the semantic part, the background subtraction part becomes the bottleneck. But don't worry. There exists one algorithm that we all hold dear in our hearts, and you all know it. Ladies and gentlemen, the famous Vibe algorithm. This bad boy can run at 200 FPS and is still, up to this day, the fastest on the market. It's thus a completely natural choice in our setup. But as you will see, its speed is not its only advantage.
Okay, so we've said previously that most background subtraction algorithms are made of three components. Remember? A background model, a distance function, and an update strategy for the background model. Well, the update strategy of Vibe has the particularity that only the pixels that were classified as background are updated in the background model. This is also called a conservative update strategy. In this setup, the semantic information does not impact the update strategy of the background model. But we've seen that the output with the semantic mask is way better. Hence, we decide to use this output instead of the output of Vibe to update the background model. This will have a positive effect on Vibe, as the background model will be updated with better features. Hence, we will have a better output of Vibe, and so on and so forth. So before we move on to the experiment, let's recap how our method works. We have a very fast background subtraction algorithm, Vibe, that provides a motion mask for each frame. In parallel, we can only provide a semantic segmentation mask once every few frames. For the frames with semantics, we can apply the semantic background subtraction method to improve the motion mask. When we don't have semantics, we use a change detection algorithm to see if the previous semantic information is still valid. If the pixel has not changed too much, we repeat the previous semantic decision. This allows to perform some semantic corrections, even when no semantic information is available for that pixel. Finally, as a cherry on the cake, we reuse the final motion mask as a feedback for the update strategy of Vibe. Now let's see how it performs on one of the most famous datasets for motion detection.
The performances are evaluated on the famous change detection dataset, also called CDNet 2014. It is composed of 11 categories with different difficulties, such as dynamic background, thermal imagery, or intermittent object motion. The semantic segmentation network used in this work is PSPNet, which is one of the state-of-the-art semantic segmentation algorithms. This network is trained on the AD20K dataset, so it's not trained specifically on the CDNet videos. This is important, as no component of RTSBS is trained on the videos of CDNet. Thus, it can be considered as an unsupervised method. This network can provide semantic information at 5 frames per second. This means that for 25 FPS video, it can provide the semantic information once every 5 frames. But of course, this can vary depending on the hardware it is computed on. For the sake of completeness, the results are provided as if PSPNet could run at any frame rate. So, it will range from each frame having access to the semantic information to only 1 frame per second.
Okay, let's start with the performance of the original Vibe algorithm. It has a F1 score of about 0.62, independently of the frame rate of the semantic information, as it does not use it. Now, let's take a look at the performance of our method. As you can see, the performances are well above the ones of Vibe, and they drop very slowly as the semantic frame rate is reduced. Just a reminder, the performances at x equals 1 correspond to the semantic background subtraction method, when semantics is available for each frame. At this point, you might wonder how useful our change detection algorithm is. I mean, what would happen if we tried different strategies? For example, we can always repeat the previous semantic decision, instead of checking if the pixel is still the same. Here is the performance of such an approach. As you can see, the performances quickly drop and even get worse than the original Vibe algorithm at some point. On the counterpart, we could also never repeat the previous decision and always trust the background subtraction algorithm when no semantic is available. As you might guess, this does not work well, and we quickly get close to the performances of Vibe, so it seems that our way to proceed is the best. This shows that we desperately need to check if the pixel still belongs to the same object. What about the usefulness of the semantic feedback? Well, for all semantic frame rates, we have a huge increase, and this is a fantastic result. Now let's see how our approach compares to the state-of-the-art algorithms. If we take the top 5 unsupervised algorithms on CDNet, we can see that RTSBS comes close in terms of performances, but with one main difference, is that our method is real-time.
Okay, it's now time to have a look at some motion detection masks. With RTSBS, the motion mask is now way closer to the ground truth. The improvements come both from the background and the foreground. For example, the moving leaves in the trees are not considered in motion anymore, and the cars and people are better segmented overall. Okay, let's give a few extra results. RTSBS has 4 parameters that can be tuned, 2 in the SBS part and 2 in the color thresholds of the change detection algorithm. In the experiments shown so far, the parameters were tuned once and for all for the entire dataset. What can be done is to tune them also for each video separately. By doing so, the performance goes from 0.74 to almost 0.83 in the F1 score. Finally, in this work, the choice of the background subtraction algorithm was the vibe algorithm. But besides the feedback, RTSBS can be used with any background subtraction algorithm, even the non-real-time ones. So, RTSBS has been tested with several of the top background subtraction algorithms. Each time, an improvement in performance could be noted. More precisely, if we take a look at the performance in the rock space of the background subtraction algorithms, we can see that they all get closer to the oracle by a large amount, at no increase in the computational cost.
Okay, let's now recap what we've seen in this video. We presented a novel background subtraction algorithm called real-time semantic background subtraction that extends the semantic background subtraction algorithm for real-time applications. Our method leverages high-quality semantic information, which can be provided at any pace and independently for each pixel, and checks its relevance through time using a change detection algorithm. We showed that our algorithm outperforms real-time background subtraction algorithms and even competes with the non-real-time state-of-the-art ones. Finally, we saw that our method can be used with any background subtraction algorithms without increasing their computation time.
And that's it for today. Thank you very much for watching. We hope you enjoyed this presentation. Please contact us if you have any questions. And if you like this video, feel free to show us your support with a like and be sure to subscribe to know when we upload a new video. And see you next time!